the show where a guy who's out of mess sits the turn and sundry tries to keep up his speech. And this week we're going to talk about the IPCC. That's the International Panel on Climate Change. They don't actually do science, they just collect all the science that's done by other people. And sum it up with the report that came out a month or so ago. There's tons of information there. There's a 30-page summary. Collects all the points. So, here's my first quote.
In short, we have 12 years to drastically change the course of our future. We've already passed the point of no return to keep global temperatures below around 1 degree Celsius warmer than pre-industrial levels. The race now is to keep it from exceeding 1.5.
I mean, Canadians are probably kind of into the temperature going up 2 degrees. It's like kind of cold here. And lots of people probably prefer a little warm. But in reality, we're talking about sea level rise and all kinds of really bad things. So, probably following the IPCC second-based thing is probably a good idea.
Just 100 companies are responsible for 71% of the entire world's carbon emissions, and just 25 of those 100 are responsible for half.
So last week we learned that 29% of carbon is put in the air by cars and 29% is put in by electricity generation. And that kind of points towards, like, if these 100 companies create 50% or 71% of the carbon, it kind of means that one of them or some of them are car companies and electric companies, because they make 29 plus 29. 58%. So the whole thing becomes pretty dependent on trying to convince these 71, 100 companies to change. It's like all up them. It's not about local people changing their light bulbs and stuff. It's about those huge companies changing what they're doing.